lot of foresight, because we all need it in the very near future. Without further ado, now I would like to hand over to Taksikan Sivadasan of the 2019 batch to start this event. Over to you, Taksikan.
Okay. Can I share the screen?
Yeah, I think you should be able to share.
Screen is visible, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I will start. Okay. So today the thing is importance of language. So I titled this as the importance of language in clinical rotations. So you are going to introduce to the clinical settings, I think next month, July. So you got, I think after you facing the basic sciences stream exam, you are now in the applied sciences stream. So you don't have the rough idea about, I think you, I also know that, got to know that you are not exposed to any clinical orientation. So I just include that. I also include some clinical introduction, and then I go with the how the language is important in the clinical rotations. Okay, so then I will go. So I am going to give three objectives. So one is introduction to clinical rotations, because I put this because you are not have any orientation regarding the clinical thing. So without knowing that, going to tell only the language thing is not valid. So I just brief introduction to the clinical things. And I put second objective as what are the components of history. So in the clinical thing, the main thing is history and examination. So the with the components of history, the language is bounded. So we have to know that. And then other one is introduction to importance of language in history. So altogether, first objective I will discuss, and then I will discuss B and C as together in the follow. And also I made some demonstration videos with my colleague, and I will share with the in the course of my this presentation. So first one is objective A. Objective A. So what is clinical? So to be make interactive, so can I just randomly pick some names? So so anyway, Senduran. So any idea about clinicals? So what is clinicals?
Clinicals is that we should go to the wards to learn from the patients rather than just sitting in the lecture hall and listening to lectures.
Yeah, that's the thing. So at the end of our journey of this medical school, we have to see, we have to treat patients. So ultimate motive of our studying is to treat patients. Without treat or communicate with patient, just reading the book is not enough. So the thing is, we have to apply our knowledge into the into the patient. So that's the main goal. So that's why clinicals is more important. And there are, in our curriculum, there is, so one year, you have basic science stream. And then after that, you are introduced to clinicals. So in our curriculum, nearly 4.5 years, we are introduced to clinicals, because so that is the importance of the clinical. So you just finished the basic sciences, now you are in applied sciences, but anyway you are introduced to clinical sciences team. That's the thing. And then after the applied sciences, you are introduced to clinical sciences team. But even though you are not knowing about the clinical sciences team, you are introduced to the clinical rotation. So that's the thing. So, and then first appointment. So normally in the first appointment thing, you are, half of the batch is allocated to medicine appointment, and then another half to the surgery appointment. So you have to, in the first appointment should be 4 weeks, and then there should be orientation by the clinical department. That's also come. Okay. So, and then what are the main components in the clinical? So there should be, so in the start to the end, there are two components, history and examination. So that carries the lot of thing in our clinical. So in both components, so in the history and examination, our language is, so communication with the patient is very much important. So we have to get the information from the patient, and then we have to, in the examination, the patient also, we have to instruct them properly. If we are not instruct them properly, we can't get the results as we expected. Okay, so main components in our clinicals is history and examination. Okay, so and then what is this medicine and then surgery? So at the end of the final year, you are have 5 main streams in clinical science, so that you have to pass to finish your medical school. That medicine, surgery, pediatrics, psychiatry, and gynecology and obstetrics. So in this main 5 stream, in medicine and surgery, you are exposed. So in medicine and surgery, you have 3 appointments. So each consists of 4 weeks duration. And then before finishing your applied sciences, before starting the applied, starting the clinical sciences stream, you are finishing 8 weeks. So only have, you only have 4 weeks after the clinical sciences stream. So anyway, you have to, okay. Then I am going to objective B and C. So what is history taking? So any idea about history taking? So anyone? I randomly pick Dajanthan. What is history taking? Any idea? Do you have any idea about history taking? Dajanthan? Oh, anyone?
Taking information of the patients.
Basically it's dry, but so it's not just the information, that's the thing. So the history taking suggests, so as the term implies, the history suggests the information from the patient, but it's like deep. So anyway, so like we are different from the collecting information from the normal person. So normal person, so normal people also ask questions from the patient. So what happened? But we are different because we have to come to the diagnosis. So the thing is, so ultimate end of the history taking is we have to come to the diagnosis. So we can't come to the definitive diagnosis. Diagnosis means, so what is the disease the patient? Yeah. So, but anyway, we have to come. So is this, we can, with the history taking, we have to exclude some kind of fact and then come into the diagnosis. That's the thing. So that is history taking. Okay. Then, so what are the components of history? So then I will, from this point onwards, I correlate with the language part. Okay. So first component is introduction. Okay. So first, we have to introduce ourselves to the patient, right? So that means consent. So without their consent, like consent, we can't speak with them. Like we have to take consent. Like, we are studying in this, we are from this medical school, and then we are going to take the history from from you, do you prefer to tell the information to us? I think most of the patients in our NHSLC thing is they consent to take the history. So some of them reluctant to tell. But anyway, we have to introduce ourselves and then ask them whether they can give the information to us or not. So in the introduction, after the consent, we have to do the introduction. So in the introduction part, we have 5 components. So first one is name. Just anyway, we have to identify. So we had asked name. So as in our clinical setting, so most of the patients are speaking in understand and speak in singular. So anyway, we have to take history from them. So we can use we have to fluent or we have to manage in the singular language. In the course of the clinical, we can find. So we have to know some terminology, basic terminology. So you are here for 1 year. So anyway, you're familiar with this thing I just mentioned. So name, so you can ask, so what is your name? That's the first one. And then we have to ask the general details. So that's the thing. Third one, sex, whether they are male or female, you can. Then, so you can use that phrase. So occupation means rasa. So that are info, because we collect this information because each information is important to come into the diagnosis. For example, I take the thing, if the patient complains chest pain, so with the age, the diagnosis will be different. So if the patient age is very young, like in 90s or 20s, we don't consider this as a heart attack. So myocardial infarct, we can't consider. But if the patient is in like 50, 60 years old, and then he is smoking, so in that patient come with a chest pain, we have to consider heart attack as the priority. So that's the difference. So anyway, every component in our history has some importance. So that's the thing. So we have to ask their age. So with the age and the patient complaint, we can narrow down our diagnosis. So the point of taking the history is to narrow down our diagnosis. It's not like interviewing or just kind of thing. So like we are funneling the information there are a lot of information patient telling. So with that information, we are funneling the thing, and then finally we can come into the diagnosis. Then we do some examination, and then we do examination, and then we narrow down our thing further. Then we ask for the investigation thing. So after that, we do some investigation, and then we come to the definitive diagnosis. That is the flow of our clinical practice. So the first part of the history taking is
first part of our history taking. Am I audible, right? Hello?
Yeah, now it's better.
Hello?
Yeah, Sashika, you can continue.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, okay. So in the end, so
So in the introduction pass, we have to ask the name and age, that mean in single voice, and then sex, then occupation. So these are the phrases that you need to know. That's the thing. And then address, and then martial status. So address means, I forget to fill that, I will fill that. And then martial status. So married means bandalada, oya bandalada nadda. So that's, these are the things important, because so this thing is important because if he is married, so we ask whether they marry, whether the patient is married or not. So if he is married, he will be a like breadwinner of the family. So and any breadwinner of the family. So that's, so everything is depend, everyone in the family is dependent on him. So that affects her social life. So that affects the mental status also. So that's why that's important. So everything in the history is, everything in the history is important. So I just tell, so I will share some video, okay. So it's a demonstration. It's a demonstration like I will do with my friend, and then I for this and I share that. Okay. Am I audible, right? Hello.
Yeah, you are.
So it's the demonstration of what I am telling now, okay? So first thing is he is doing is introduce.
මගේ ගෙවල් පුංචි
කරන්නේ
රස්සාව කරනවා මට ගන්න ගන්නේ ඔෆිස් එක වැඩ
කරන්නේ එතකොට මේ පාර හොස්පිටල් එකට ආවේ
so Senduran, am I audible? So I can't hear your voice. So it's...
Yeah,
okay. I know I can play. So if the video is clear, right?
Yes.
Okay. So in that video, in this first part, so that's introduction. So he asked for my name. So oyage nama mogakda. Then oyage vayasa kiyada. And then oya koyade inne ara the answer. So it's like, so I just from the video I like to create some, so what is in clinical setting. So it not should be like whether the patient is giving consent in all the settings, whether patient is not giving consent in all the settings. So it's like a prototype history taking I demonstrate with my friend. Okay, so that's the first thing. And then the main part of the history taking is presenting complaint. So presenting complaint means, so what? So patient, what is the main complaint of this patient? So what is the main complaint of this patient? So patient can come for the hospital for food many times, and then he So if you see a patient in the ward, he's come, he's followed for nearly like 10 years, so 15 years if he, for diabetes or some other diseases. But if he is in the ward this time, you have to ask, what is the thing, what is the complaint he admitted this time, not for the past time. So presenting complaint mean what is the complaint that make us patient to admit this hospital now. So for example, if the patient, so 60 year old patient, he has diabetes for 15 years, hypertension for 10 years, and then he has past history of myocardial infarction, and now in the medicine ward, you ask from the, when you go to the ward and then ask from the patient, so that means what difficulty you have, they tell lot of story like I have diabetes for 15 years, I have hypertension for 10 years, I have heart attack. So don't deviate from that sense, because you can't say to the consultant or doctor consultant he has diabetes for 15 years as the first thing. So the first thing is you have to tell them what is the presenting complaint. So what makes us to the hospital now. So he can admit it for even for the simple fever. You have to ask, so why this time you have admitted? So this time means in singular then. So then oya you means oya means you. So then oya admit vune, then oya admit vune hedu mogada. So for what reason you admit to this now. So that's the thing. So in the presenting complaint part, there are many presenting complaints. So I just list out the presenting complaints. So in the medicine ward, you can see the presenting, you encounter presenting complaint, fever. So fever means una in single. I'll tell in single that. So these are the things: fever, chest pain, shortness of breath, chronic cough or hemoptysis. Hemoptysis means like blood in the patient when coughing, he expectorates blood. So that's the thing. Edema means swelling. So swelling of the abdomen. And then jaundice. Jaundice means yellowish discoloration of the skin. And then joint pain, bleeding and bruising. And then lower limb weakness, hemiparesis. So for the final years, so the main presenting complaints are this. So in our world also, most of the patient are 15 to this complaint. So you have to ask the patient, so I or I admit bune, why you were admitted to his hospital this time. So I means why. So I or I admit bune, admit bune. So they tell for the fever. So una haduna. So that's the thing. So fever means una. Then chest pain means papua kekuma. So normally they use papua kekuma, papua amaru, or papua vedana. So they can tell different things, but all are suggesting the chest pain. So papua means chest and kekuma means pain. So papua kekuma or papua vedana or papua amaru. So they use these things. They tell these things. And then shortness of breath. This is the common complaint. So if you go to the medicine ward, you encounter this. Husma ganna amaru. So husma amaru means difficulty. So difficulty in breathing. So that's the thing. Shortness of breathing means difficulty in breathing. So amaru means difficulty. Husma ganna means like breathing. So husma ganna amaru. So that's the presenting complaint. So if you go to the ward and ask the patient, I admit tune, they tell that doctor matter husma ganna amaru. So you have to build on this presenting complaint. And then you have to finally come to the diagnosis. So there are a lot of cause for the chest pain. There are a lot of cause for the shortness of breath. So if the patient tells husma ganna amarunam, you have to guess shortness of breath. And then with the age and then other information, you have to funnel it. And then you have to come into the diagnosis. It's like a detective, right? Okay. Then cough. I mentioned the title of the long cases, so that cough means kasa. So if they come with if you ask for the patient, so like consider that patient, consider you, you got fever and cough. So what is your presenting complaint? Una haduna. Fever means there are a lot of differential, there are a lot of things. So, and then if you asked, you then ask, the fever can be from the simple respiratory infection. If they tell, kasa thiyenawa, and then you, and sema. Sema means sputum. So, kasa thiyenawa. Kasa means cough. So, kasa thiyenawa and sema thiyenawa. So, sema means sputum. So, this. From this, you can narrow down the thing into respiratory infection. At this, at, for example, at with 22-year-old male or female come with fever, with cough, and then runny nose means in single hemorrhisav. So with come, you can ask, you can come into the diagnosis. Is this just a simple respiratory infection? That's how you are working out. Okay. So, huff means kasa, and then chronic means you can, don't go and directly search in Google translator for the chronic cough. So, you can use like simple terms. So, in like loko means in single big. So, kalayak means time. So, loko kalayak kasa tiyanavada. You can ask. So, tiyanavada means whether they have or not. So, if the patient says kasa, you can ask. How long? So how long means loko kalaya kasa thiyenawada. Loko kalaya kasa thiyenawada means if they say yes, so that's, you can build up from that presenting complaint. So that's the thing. And edema means idimila. So if you go, if the patient is coronary kidney disease or heart failure, they develop edema. So idimila. So from just like insect bite also, they develop swelling. So they can complain. So mata kakul means leg. So mage kakul dekama idimuna. So from that you have to work it out. So that's the thing. So for that you have to know the phrases, that know the phrases in singular to understand the what, to understand what the patient says. Okay, then anyway, this is also same. So, swelling of the abdomen that we call ascites. So, that means abdomens mean like bada idimuna. They can sell idimuna. So, from this edema means swelling, neither swelling means idimuna. So, abdomen, swelling of the abdomen means bada idimuna. Or bada lokuvela. Loku means, I think you know this, you use this word much. So, bada means like abdomens, and then loku means big, so bada lokuvela. So that's the presenting complaint. That's what the patient is saying. Okay. Then jaundice. Jaundice means yellowish discoloration of the body. So they tell that yellow means kaha. Harida. So mage aga means like body. So mage aga is, I put as S. As means like eyes. So, mage aga as kaha pata una. So, kaga means yellow. So, they tell that. So, like if the patient seems alcoholic, patient seems to be alcoholic, and then you when you take the EC, he said that I am, he said that doctor mata mage aga kaha pata una. And then you ask, you can see the eyes, and then you can ask asut kaha pata unada. Asut means like eyes also become yellowish. They, you can get the information from the patient. So, and then joint pain. Joint means handi. So handi kakuma. Kandi hakuma tiyanada. So pains means kakuma. You can so don't like don't make big sentences. So like with simple sentences you can ask from the patient. Don't use the like the written languages. So simple sentences you can develop. So that's why I mentioned, so joint means handi, and then kakuma means pain. So handi rida handi kakuma tiyanawada naththam handi vedanawada handi amaru. So you can use any kind of thing. So I put three things because they complain different thing. So handi vedanavada means they tell handi vedanavada. But if you know one thing, you can't understand it. So that's why you put three things. And then if the hemophilia patient, they think they presented with lay anava. So mata spontaneous means nikam. So mata nikam lay anava. So that will be the presenting complaint. Okay. Then lower limb weakness. Lower limb weakness means like lower limb means legs. So leg means kakula. Hakula pala nati una. So that's the presenting complaint for the lower limb weakness. So when you are going to the wards, so these are the main type of presenting complaint. That's why I put this as I am telling the singular phrases for these sentences. Okay. And then in the surgery. So in the surgery, there are in the surgery also there are some presenting complaints. So I am categorizing this because in our ward, these are the main presenting complaints. So in the surgery ward, you can encounter dysphagia. So dysphagia means difficulty in swallowing. So and then perrectal bleeding. Perrectal bleeding means so from the rectum they are bleeding. So that's the common presenting complaint, and then abdominal pain, and the lump, and the breast, any kind of breast pathologies, and then hematuria, and then lower urinary tract syndrome. These are the main presenting complaint in surgery. If you are going to the surgery ward, you are encounter these type of presenting complaint. So if you see a patient, if you ask, they tell that I have lump. So lump means gediak. So mata gediak tiyanava. They can tell mata gediak tiyanava. So you ask, yeah. So koyeda. So they tell that mage belalanga, bela means neck. So mage belalanga gediyak tiyenawa. So you can say that's the neck lump. So that's the thing. So dysphagia means difficulty in swallowing. So difficulty means amaru. So you know the simple phrases and then make it yourself. So amaru means, so dysphagia means difficulty in swallowing. So swallowing means gilinna. So amaru means difficulty. So gilinna amaru. Or they can tell gilinna apasu. So apasu means like discomfort. So they can say discomfort. So they have used different things. So gilinna means swallowing. So difficulty in swallowing means gilinna amaru. Okay. Then perrectal bleeding. So perrectal bleeding, they can say different thing. They say, if you ask from the patient, like they say that doctor mage toilet karna gota leyenava toilet ekka yenava. So that's the thing. So this malapagam means like very if the patient is very old, they tell malapaga. So this is more towards written language, but most of the patient tells toilet ekka leyenava. Ley means, you know, like blood. Yanava means it's going. So toilet ekka late janava. So they use the most of the word we use with ekka means like plus. So here we use some malapaga means like they, if the patient is very old and then they said malapaga samaga le yanava, but most of the patient tell toilet ekka doctor mage toilet karna gota toilet tackle, jail and all. These are the presenting complaints you heard from the patient when you are going to the first appointment. That's the thing. And then abdominal pain. Most of the patient complain in the surgery ward. So same, bada kekuma. So bada kekuma. So why I am telling this presenting complaint in single is from the presenting complaint you are to work. So if the patient from the, and also in the first appointment also, you were consulted and asked, so what is the presenting complaint in this patient? So tell the history. So in the history, they expect in the first appointment to elaborate on the presenting complaint. So that's what they want in the first appointment. So I made the presentation on that thing. Okay. So bada kekuma means abdominal pain. Then you have to develop. Okay. And then lum means gediyak or gatiyak or idimumak. So most of the patients says gediyak. Doctor, if you ask in the clinic, most of in the surgery clinic, they ask, so I oya I clinic aave. So I means why clinic. Clinic, you can use clinic. Clinic, you can use. So don't go to found single word for everything. So these are the normal word, ne? Clinic, clinic. So clinic, you can use that word. So I oya clinic aave. Aave means why you are coming to the clinic. So they said that they will say gediya. So gediyak tiyenawa. Gediyak tiyenawa means la. In our surgery setting, most of the patients say neck lump. So mage bella bellin gediyak tiyenawa or bella idimuna. So they can say, so that's the thyroid lump. So that can be thyroid. So that presenting complaint is the so in the if the consultant or anyone asks what is the presenting complaint, you don't have to say the diagnosis thyroid lump. You have to tell there's a neck lump in neck. There's a neck lump. So the patient presented with neck lump, and also you have to tell the duration. So in the presenting complaint, you have to in the presenting complaint part, you have to tell why the patient this time come to the hospital and then duration of the symptom. So if the patient come with abdominal pain for 1 week duration, you have to tell the patient come with abdominal pain for 1 week duration. So that's the thing. Then with other part, that the history of presenting complaint bar, you elaborate on that symptoms and then finally come into the diagnosis. That's the thing. Okay. And then diseases of the breast, they are this like umbrella term, they sell pavaruvala ledakti and most of them are reluctant to say like what's the condition. So they are saying mage pavaruvala ledakti enavada pavaruvara gediyakti enavada mage pavaru indala le enavada. So nipple discharge, so these are the complaint of them. So these suggest whether the disease is in the breast or not. Then you have to ask, for example, if the patient tell mage nipple discharge, okay, so like pavaru indala that's the presenting moment. Then you have to elaborate how long. So they tell that for 1 week duration or 1 month duration. So nipple discharge for 1 month duration. And then you can ask, make it's blood stained or not. So if it is blood stained, it goes toward malignancy. So that's the follow for your diagnosis. Okay, that's a work, that's a flow chart for your diagnosis. Okay, then hematuria means when urinating blood bleeding. So mutra tekka leyanava. So that is all the presenting complaint. So and then LUTS mean lower urinary tract symptom. So they tell that mata mutra karana amari mutra yanne mang ara they are straining, but they don't they can't able to urinate properly. So that's the lower urinary tract symptoms. Okay, so I will share the video. Sound is coming, right? Video sound is coming, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mage Vaisa Hakti.
So this is the thing, this is the question and this is the answer. Mepara means this time hospital agata. So the hospital agata ave means come by came kove mogakda. So what is the reason? So that's the term you can use. So before going in, I elaborate into the presenting complaint, I will show this video. So the first part is done and then presenting complaint also done. So he asked for the question. So why you came to hospital this time? So Ioya hospital lagata ave. So I responding like Papua Kekuma Haduna. So that's my presenting complaint. So that what you wrote in the history. So first part introduction you wrote, and then in the presenting complaint you wrote chest pain. For he asked kavadda une. Kavadda means when. So kavadda une ea means yesterday. So for 1 day duration chest pain, when did he have chest pain? Yesterday. So that's the thing. Okay, so I will play this video and then I will show the slide. Okay, so carefully watch. Okay, so what now he is doing was analyzing the presenting complaint. So that's the thing I want to show. Okay, so I start from here. Okay, so history of presenting complaint. So first part is introduction. Introduction means, so general introduction of the patient. So in that case, he said that, so Nama, they should sashit, and then vayasa 48, so 48. So these, those things that in numbers, those things you can learn from your colleague, that one means ekka tuna. So that basic thing you have to learn, and then prasava karnavala. So where did he working? So that also he asked, and then presenting complaint also asked. Now he elaborating on the presenting complaint. That was the history work. Okay. So history of presenting complaint. So third part of the history, what history of presenting complaint? So in the first appointment, you have to be fluent in presenting complaint and history of presenting complaint. So that's where you get the most of the marks in our exam. So that's the main thing. So in the history of presenting complaint, there are in the history of presenting complaint, there are six parts. Okay, symptom analysis, symptom analysis. So that's what he is doing. So I said papua kakuma, that means chest pain. The what he was doing is, the medical student, the other side, my colleague was doing, was he is analyzing the symptom. He analyzed symptoms very well, like I said papua kakuma, so chest pain. They analysis. So he analyzed the pain. So when did you get the pain? And then when did you get the pains? Mean how the oyata kakuma une? And then where is the pain? Tell the exact location. So kotanada ridenne. And then how long? Kochara velava tibbe. So I said 30 minutes. And then what are the other features? What are the other features? And what are the other features? I said Dadiya Dhamma means sweatings. And then these are the questions he is asking from me. And then he also asked some leading questions. So leading question mean, so he asked from me, you have any other associated syndrome in Singala? Vena Monahari Ledak, Vena Monahari Amari Tibbada. Here I said Vamanagi, Dadiya Dhamma. And then I only said Dadiya Dhamma. Dadiya Dhamma means I sweating. And then he asked some leading question. You have any other thing? Any other thing? So these are the things. So if the patient come with chest pain and then some autonomic syndrome like sweating, those kind of thing, and then the pain is not settled with the rest, those kind of thing suggest heart attack. So here I demonstrating the typical history of acute coronary syndrome. So acute coronary syndrome means like myocardial, for your level you can think is that myocardial infarction. Not only the myocardial infarction come under the ACS, but so you can think is that. So the history I was demonstrating, what typical history of myocardial infarction. Okay, symptom analysis. So in this case, the symptom is pain, chest pain. I am analyzing the, he is analyzing the chest pain. And then excluding DD. So other thing I, other part, with the throw I will, I am telling. So these are the part of the history of presenting complaint. So first one is symptom analysis. Other one is excluding DD. So DD means differential diagnosis. I will come into that point later. And then what has been done so far, possible etiology, complication status, and systemic review. These are the part of history of presenting complaint. So we have to ask all the questions. So from the first appointment, you are well enough to do the symptom analysis, and you are well enough to find out the, exclude the differential, other differential, excluding the differential diagnosis, you will learn other things in other appointments. Okay, other, go through appointments. Okay, so what is symptom analysis? So symptom analysis means just we are analyzing the symptom. We have some, so here the symptom is pain. So for example, for pain, so pain means vedanava kakkuma amare. So any type of pain, if I am telling I have hand pain, or I have chest pain, I have back pain. Back means from the kakuma. So if any pain, you have to analyze it. You can use the mnemonic Socrates. So that what he is doing. The Socrates suggests S means sight, onset, character, radiation. Radiation, associated features, timing, exacerbating factors, and then severity. So that's what he is doing. So what is so great is, so site, he asked Kottanada Ridhani. So Kottanada means where? So I tell that in the left side. So that's the thing. And then onset, Kohomada Patangadde. So Evelavat Mama Mogadakare. So what I am doing at that time, I said that typing. So that's the thing, that's what he is doing. So second part of the thing is history of presenting complaint. So initially he asked for the chest pain and then he elaborate on the chest pain. So this Socratic mnemonic you can use for the all type of pain. Okay, site, onset. And then correct, he asked the he asked like tadakaranna wage da tadakaranna wage da ara patiya means like belt patiya dala tadakaranna wage da like putting the belt and like pressing. So that's the thing here, that's type of pain come in the cartilage. So those question he asked. Okay, then radiation, he asked it going to the shoulder or neck. So kakkuma vena koke gari yanavada. So those thing you can. So radiation means the pain is radiated. So in the myocardial infarction, you all know like chest pain is radiated to the shoulder joint or in the neck region. So that's the thing he asked. And then associated features, vena amaruvak tiyanavada. He asked vena amaruvak tiyanavada. I said that sweating, the idea them. And then he asked leading question. He knows some set of question for the myocardial infarction. And then he asked that question. Okay. And then timing, kochara velavak tibunada. He asked kochara velavak tibunada. I said in that demonstration video, 30 minutes. So that's the thing. And then exacerbating factors. He asks, Vedanava, Monavadanisa, Vadi Wundi, or Adu Wundi. So he, in the, exacerbating factors and relieving factors. And then severity. Severity means Vedanava, Kochara, Lokuda, or Lokuna. Vedanava means pain. Kochara means like how much. Lokuda means like how big is that. So that's the thing. Exacerbating factors and relieving factors. I forgot to mention the relieving factors. You can also add relieving factor. Vedanava, monava. Vedanava means kakkuma. Monava nisa. Nisa means like nisa means for. So monova means what? Nisa means I can't say the direct meaning. So vedanava monova nisa vadi venne. So what the things exacerbate the pain. So vedanava means pain, monova means what the things, nisa means reason. Reason monavada nisa. So nisa vadi venne, vadi means big, vadi venne means into increase, the means normally we put for the question. So an associated features, vena means like vena means other, amaruak means the normal, the amaru difficulty, tiyanavada means do you have. So vena amaruvak tiyanavada. Vedanava means pain or kakkuma. Kakkuma vena kohegari. Vena means other. Kohegari means like any region. Here I type it as padirenavada, but you can use yanavada. So that's the thing most of the patient under. So vedanava vena kohegari yanavada. So so pain is radiating to other places. And then correct, vedanava monava geda. These things most of the patient can't understand. So you have to give some clues. Vedanava means kakkuma, monava geda means, what type? Monava geda means what type is that? pain. So he tell that tadagaranamage means like putting something and pressing. So that's thing. And then some time patient complain burning type pain, burning gastritis patient complain burning type pain. Burning type mean pitcher never again. So those are the correct thing. Okay. Onset, coma the patangade. Onset, coma, onset means coma the patangade. So onset also important because if the onset is acute, it suggests some serious cause. So onset for 3 months suggests, so it goes for the different reason. Okay. So kohomada means how patangade means started, how it started. So ekaparatada means acute. Ekaparada means acute. Ekaparada means acute. Tika tika in the means like tika tika vadi unala. Tika tika means like slow slow and it come to the it's like what? It's initially it's very low and then it increase. So that's the thing. Okay. So this is the thing. Okay. Okay, differential diagnosis part. So differential diagnosis means like if the patient complained over chest pain, there are a whole lot of causes. So that is the differential diagnosis. Okay, so can I ask some questions? Okay, so Lojita. No, Jitan. Sahana. Hello. Okay. So differential diagnosis means like for the chest pain, there are different causes. So that is the differential diagnosis. So the main important thing in the history is to come into the diagnosis. For that, we have to know the differential diagnosis. So if we take the chest pain, so if the patient says about the chest pain means papua kakuma, there are whole lot of differential diagnosis. So we have to exclude this type of differential diagnosis. So in the chest region, there is heart. So there is a cardiovascular related causes. And also in the chest region, there is a lung. So there are lungs related causes and also some GI tract related causes also causing chest pain. And then it's like simply a muscle pain. So if the patient is come with a trauma or any kind of like hit to that area, so if we have simple muscle pain, so we have to exclude all that. So if the patient come and tell the chest pain, you have to think about the differential diagnosis. So in the differential diagnosis, these are the differential diagnosis. So and with the age and the associated symptoms, okay. So I will play the video. So he asking for after the pain, what did you do? So that's the thing. So the patient definitely do something in the home. So that is important. So that's what he asking. So in that thing, so initially the patient complained about the chest pain. So chest pain, and then the analysis the symptoms. So he analyzes the symptoms, and then he using the Socrates, this thing. And then he come into some diagnosis with this analysis, because the patient complained about the chest pain radiating to the shoulder. So then he come into the diagnosis as the some kind of diagnosis like heart attack, and then he for the other part of the presenting complaint. So etiology or risk factor. So that's why he asked for the diabetes. I mean diabetes. So that's the thing goes. Okay.
කියක් කියලා දවසට
බලනවා දවසට තුනක්
දවසට තුනක් ආදාම
මොනවද
ඒකට දැන් කොච්චර කාල වෙනවද සිගරට් බොන්න පටන් ගන්න
ඌ පටන් ගත්තේ අවුරුදු මට වයස අවුරුදු 20 ඒ කාලේ ඉඳලා දැන් වෙනකම්
මොනවද
ඔඩිෂන්
අවශ්‍ය කරනවා
this is the thing. So he is going to ask for the etiology and the risk factors and the patient smoke, whether he's smoking or taking alcohol, those kind of things. Okay. This is the thing. Okay. Then.
එන්න කලින් දවසේ අහක්ලිම වැඩිපුර දිව්වද පවුලේ අම්මට තාත්තා කොලෙස්ටරෝල්
So this is the thing. So what has been done so far? So for that thing, I answered the question. So
maybe
So he is asking for at what time he came to the hospital. Okay, so that's the thing. So what he asking and so So what is he asking was, so what has been done so far? So initially he asked for the peace presenting complaint, chest pain. Then he asked for elaborate the history of presenting complaint. And then he got to, he exclude the DD. So that part, I think that's too much for you. So that I exclude that part. So excluding DD means like, he exclude the differential diagnosis. The differential diagnosis mean, so if the chest pain in diagnosis, there are a whole lot of differential diagnosis. So there are a set of questions to ask to exclude the DD. So that's what he asked to exclude the other causes for chest pain. Like, so he excludes the pneumonia and then pulmonary embolism also we have to exclude. So that's why he asked for the long travel karada. So that's us. And then other part is what has been done so far, that's what he asking. So initially he asked after you come here, what are the things did? So I said aspirin dunna, and then he asking. So that's come, that's how he take the information from the paper. So this is the the analysis of history of presenting complaint for the chest pain. Okay. And then other thing. Other components. He also asked for the past medical. He also asked past medical history. So sometimes it's come to the risk factors. So in the case of the chest pain history, it comes as risk factors. So past diabetes and cholesterol, hypertension are risk factors. Sometimes there are some conditions not related to the presenting complaint come into the part of past medical history. So if the patient comes with the fever and then you elaborate the symptoms, and then if he said he has diabetes, or if he has pressure, it comes under the past medical history. And then past surgical history. If this patient said I had done appendicectomy in the teenage, so it comes under the past surgical history, not in the history of presenting complaint. And then drug history or autoimmersion, what are the drugs he is taking? So that's why he asked. Here he asked, okay. So he asked, did you have any other disease? And then I am answering. So this is the part of past medical history of the practitioner.
Doctors
හැමදාම චෙක් කරනවා සීනි ප්‍රෙෂර් එක
නෑ හැමදාම අර මම චෙක් කරනකොට ගියපාර අර අවුරුදු දෙකට වැඩි චෙක් කරනකොට වැඩිම තිබ්බා ඒ හින්දා මම අර චෙක් කරේ නෑ ඊට පස්සේ
අවුරුදු
දෙකකට
සිගරට් බොනවාද
මම සිගරට් බොනවා
so these are the things and past medical history, surgical history, drug history, and allergy history. He also asked for the allergies. Allergies monogari tiyanada. So you have to ask for the allergies. I mean to the pluses. Allergies tiyanada. Allergies tiyanada. Do we have allergies? You don't need some. You can just use allergies tiyanada. So that's enough. And then menstrual history and family history and social history. So these are the components. Okay. So, and I want to demonstrate another video regarding here chest pain I put for the surgery medicine part. And I also demonstrate some video for the surgery thing. Okay. This is the surgery part. So initially the same workout. So initially he go for the consent and then he take the history from the patient. So initial part is finished. So he asked for the details of the introduction and then he asked for why you are coming to the hospital this time. So අය ඔයා හොස්පිටල් එකටද මේ පාර ඔයා හොස්පිටල් එකට ආවේ මොකටද නිසා මොකද නිසා So this is the thing I said because he asked, he told he has lump for 3 months duration, but he specifically asked from him like Ioya me parave. So they have 3 months duration, but why did you come this time? So that's the thing. And then so he asked for how did you noticed? So that means how did oya homada danagatte. So I will share this video with you after the sound is okay, it's low.
Now it's fine.
When did it show? In the initial part? No. It stopped from the initial part or from the middle?
From the middle.
From the middle. Okay.
ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್
කලින් ඔපරේෂන් කොට කරලා
So this is the demonstration, like for the surgery part of the surgery history. So I think I covered all the things. So I made the demonstration video with some, like, what we experience in our ward setting. So, okay. So, any questions? Okay, then special thanks to, like, my colleagues, Sanvara, Shashita, Abarna, and Jude. So, okay. Thank you. Okay. Can I hand over to the... Sumedha?
Yes. We would like to say a very big thank to Takshik and Sivadasan of the 2019 batch for this very insightful and knowledgeable presentation. And I'm very sure that all of my fellow batchmates and anyone who needs a further understanding of the subject has gained immensely from this presentation. So to wrap up, I once again thank Darshik and Sivadasan for the presentation and the president of the Rotaract Club of Faculty of Medicine, Mr. Asil Dattanarachi, and Sanadi Ilensinger, the VP of the Professional Development Avenue, for organizing this event and making this evening possible. I would also like to thank all of the participants here today with us in this evening and making this workshop an immensely helpful thing for the future clinical practice entering of the 2021 batch. So without further ado, I wish a very good night to everyone. And please don't forget to submit your valuable feedbacks in the MedLingos group. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.